Hello, Astronaut Randy Bresnik. And communication is really vital to our operations aboard spacecraft, whether it be free-flying spacecraft or the International Space Station itself. We can talk via the radio through our satellite relays, which is really helpful. And we also are able to talk directly to the ground via the VHF radios. The third way we actually have is via the ham radio. And so we can talk to people all over the world via the ham radio. Communicating the ground is really important for several reasons. Of course, we've got to be able to conduct our experiments and be able to coordinate our efforts aboard the space station for the work that we're doing. But it also is really important for the people up there, because we're still people when we're up there as astronauts living aboard the space station for 6 months. It'd be really hard to go through all that time without talking to my wife or my kids or my friends or people like you that are out there watching us do our public affairs events. So that's going to be a real challenge for us when we start going outside of the moon, Earth orbit, and head off to Mars, where the communication delays can be up to 20 minutes, where you can't have a real-time conversation with someone. So that's where we're gonna have to figure out how to make smarter types of communication that can maybe communicate even faster than the current radios that we have now. Now, over to Marty and Beth, so you can learn more.
Thanks, comrade. As Randy said, communication with the Earth is very important, both in getting your orders from mission control and keeping in touch with family and friends.
Back in the early days of the space program, we sent men to the moon for the first time in the 1960s, and communication was vitally important. Back then, the predominant way of communicating was through line of sight. So if this is my signal, and I'm the Earth and Beth is the spacecraft, we communicate through line of sight. That signal goes back and forth between the satellite and Earth. Now, when we get to the moon, things get a little bit harder. Let's bring in the moon. Come on in, Mr. Moon. Line of sight gets much harder when something's in the way. I try to put the signal through. It cannot get through to the spacecraft on the far side of the moon.
During Apollo 11, Michael Collins went around the far side of the moon, and during that period of time, he couldn't communicate with the Earth.
This is going to continue to be an issue, particularly with long-duration spaceflight, like when we first go to Mars. So, one way to solve that is with satellites. Let's bring in satellite Michelle. So now, if this is Mars and I want to communicate from Earth with a spacecraft on the far side of Mars, I'm going to need to use a satellite. So I take the signal, I send it to the satellite to the spacecraft, and back to Earth. That's how we would communicate.
If you want to learn more about this, be sure to check out our lesson plan on our website.